Hey guys, this is Ryan. Welcome to your next Blender tutorial on Active TV. So, we're starting something new. It's not going to be for too long, but it's very, very cool, very useful. And if you've never done this before, well, today is your day. So, we're going to be creating something called Mortar. Now, what the heck is Mortar? Well, I kindly Googled it for you. You see the in-between part? They've got other names for it. Usually you find it between tiles and that as well. I suppose it's almost like a cement type of, what do they call it? There's another name for it. Anyway, that's boring. Let's move on. So, quite an interesting texture. So let's get to it. So look at us, we're starting from scratch. Hey, when last have we started from scratch? Okay, sorry, am I moving too quick there? All right, so Shift A, Mesh, Plane. All right, I'm gonna leave it that size for now. I'm going to compare that to the size of my light and I'm gonna be using my area lamp. So I'm going to take this guy. You don't have to delete it, you've just got to come to my my light properties shelf or tab, whatever you want to call this over here. There is a name for it. Change it to an area lamp. All right, I'm going to change this to 300 watts. I'm going to make sure that it is a square and I'm going to make it a meter. All right, here we go. I think while I'm at it, I might as well just reset all of these parameters over here. I think I can just right click and hit reset. Hey, default values, yeah. All right, here we go. Do you see the way I just clicked? Did you see that? Okay, if I click and drag, I alter all of them. Hit zero, bop, boom. There you go. All right, that was very useful. Then I'm gonna take my light because it's right in the center of my world at its default location, well, center. I'm going to hit G for grab, Z, because I'm going to move it in the Z axis. Then I'm going to shift it off to the side. So I'm going to hit R for rotation, Y, because I'm going to rotate in the Y axis. Then I'm going to press G for grab, X. This is moving stuff in a very particular area, specific. Yes, in a very specific area. Right. Then what I'm going to do is I am going to view frame selected. All right, and that's what we've got. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to add in an HDRI. Now, I don't know if I have any HDRIs downloaded. As you see, there it is. Okay, I actually do. Great. So why am I using an HDRI? Well, because HDRIs for me are a lot more realistic. There are different variations in the lighting, so I like that. It's not just a straightforward lighting like this one from, well, you know, like I got this lighting here, but I'm going to add in some extra full light. Okay, so on my world shelf or tab over here, I'm going to use nodes. On my color, I'm going to click on the yellow dot here. I'm going to change it to environment texture. I'm going to say new one, eyeline. I'm going to click open. I'm going to navigate to my downloads because that's where my HDRI is. There it is. This is all the other stuff that's going on in my world. My goodness, isn't that interesting? I'm going to open the image and then it is there. All right. I think I can put this at 0.200. That's what I usually put it at. Now I'm going to go into this little render view over here so we can look at a render preview. Okay, and you can see how I've got my comfy cafe around. Okay, we'll have a look, we'll make some more adjustments later. I'm going to go to my material preview and now we are going to start working on my material. The first thing that I'm going to be adding in here, because it's mortar, so which I need to add like tiles. The best place for me to, well, the best way for me to add like a tile texture, Shift A, texture, brick texture, which is not available. Why? Because I need to add a new material. Did you see that? So I've got the item selected, and you can see I need to add a brand new texture from the start. So there you go. I'm gonna say top underscore ha texture. Great, there you go. Okay, by default you got your principal shade over here. I'm gonna delete that. I'm going to right click texture, brick texture. Okie dokie. I'm gonna plug that right into there. We're gonna see the preview. Ba boom, bada bee, bada boom. There it is. Beautiful. My brick texture. All right. But now, how do you get this more into a tile texture? Well, let me show you. You change the offset to 0. Can you see where we're going? All right. Leave my frequency. Leave all of that stuff down. I'm gonna go down to my scale. Okay, 5. Very good. Now, you notice what it says? Mortar. So that's the in between. So that's why they call it mortar. All right, here we go. 0.030. Now this guy over here is your mortar smooth, right? So, oh yes. In fact, let's do this. So I'm going to select my camera. I don't have to select my camera. I can have this selected and I can just click on my camera over here. I am going to do exactly like what I did with the light. So my camera is right over here. I am going to okay, rotation, location, yes, but that's for the plane, that's not for the camera. Select my camera, drag 0, drag 0, and the only thing I think I'm gonna up . All right, let's leave that where it is. All right, not exactly what I was expecting. Anyway, let's go into the camera. I'm gonna press N. I'm gonna go to tools, view, and this option over here, camera to view, I'm gonna select it, get rid of that. What that does is that now as I navigate, so does my camera. Didn't know you could do that, did you? Right, select my item. View, frame selected, that's gonna lock the camera on that as my pivot point. And let's try that again. Camera again, not my location, my rotation. I am not winning at this, am I? All right, there you go. Move that like that. There's probably much easier ways to do this. Everybody knows an easier way. Sorry about that if we took the long way around. Right, and the reason why I want my camera like this, and I will show you. Okay, press N, unselect that, so we're not moving the camera. And so we've got our preview over here. So my brick width and height, you can set that to 1. And this is now where we get our tile look like. I'll just go to my camera. Can I rotate this to 0? There you go. Now it's looking at my tiles. See, straightforward. So let's go back here. All right. Unselect that. I don't want to move my camera, because once you move your camera, have you ever moved your camera and you press Command Z and then, yeah, you can't undo that. All right, press S, save, and personal files, lots of personal files, new folder, more top. Okay, let's save that in there. Blender file also. More top. Right, thank you very much. Okay, so now the next thing that we are going to do here, we've added the brick texture, very cool. the next thing that I would like to do, because I would like to bring this, I mean, this is, what is boring, man? Look at this, it's quite straightforward. So what we are able to do, I'm going to leave that on render right there. The first thing is that we're going to give it the brick texture itself. We're going to give it some bump. Right click, shift A, sorry. I think it's under converter. No, vector, bump. Place that, in there. I'm going to pull the factor out. Now, if you don't know this by now, let me show you what the factor looks like. Your factor is your matte. So white and black, it's either one or zero. So your factor will be white, I think will be, if I put it into my bump, I think my white, let me show you. So you'll see how it's swapped around, and that's because I'm going to, out of this brick texture, I'm only going to be affecting the white. Yes, so white is your opaque area, your black is your transparent area. Correct me if I'm wrong, comment below. So I'm going to plug that factor so we can use the color out of it, and then we are able to get this factor out of it and plug that straight into my height, and then my normal into, oh my goodness gracious me. Just realize now, how do I do that? So I think that's, it probably was a great idea. You guys are watching this right before you actually trying this out, right? So let's keep our principal shader in there. That's also gonna help us. There you go, make it look more realistic. All right, you can actually see my area lamp kicking in quite nicely there, right? So where was I? Bump map normal into normal, and when I plug that in now, we are going to see how there's actually a lift. Our tiles are starting to have dimension to it. It's not just a flat, it's actually, yes, got some texture to it. So now what we're going to do, because if you look at mortar is quite rough, so how do we do that? All right, so we're going to add in a noise texture, but I think before we add in that noise texture, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this factor that's coming in here, right? And I'm going to add some noise into it. So how do we do that? You're going to use, we're going to use a math node. I'm going to plug that in there. I'm going to change. So what math node does is there's two places where you can input values or nodes or whatever. Depending on which mode you choose, it's going to either add them together, multiply them, or you can leave plug-in one added in, and it's going to take whatever's coming in. Remember I said white is 1, black is 0, so it's either going to multiply it or whatever. It's going to do some mathematical stuff to it right there. So I'm going to leave that guy in there. I'm going to change this to multiply, and I'm going to plug in my noise texture. The factor, so your factor is your black and white map of this texture right over here. And the minute I plug that in, you're gonna immediately see some stuff happening. I am busy recording, so it's all about humanity. There you go. Now you can see that it's only affecting the black. Why is it only affecting the black? Because of this factor that we got out here. So remember, black is opacity, which means it's not going to affect that. Well, it's transparent, sorry. And yes, the black was opaque, which means it's visible. Okay, so my noise texture into my multiplier, because it's taking the one, and wherever there's white, it's brightening it up. That's why you're seeing those areas over there. So I'm going to make some adjustments on my noise texture, then we're going to adjust the bump over here. All right, so first things first, my scale, I'm gonna scale it all the way up to 200. Can you see now we are getting more that rough looking mortar that we were expecting. I'm going to crank my detail up to 10. All right. And my distortion to 0.5. Okay. All right, so there you go. Looking now at my mortar. It's looking a bit too intense. Look at that. It's a very good close-up. All right, let's not do that. But there you go. You can see what it's actually doing there. So I personally feel like the mortar is too much. So I'm going to crank it down with my bump. I'm going to bring my strength down to 0.192. And I'm going to bring my distance down to 0.1 instead. All right, you can actually see on this side over here. All right, cool. And then the last thing that you can do just to improve this, which I almost forgot about, you've got to use a texture coordinate. And that texture coordinate is going to help me place things a lot better in here. Alright, and as we start looking at this, you can actually see how the mortar is looking like way better, like a lot better. You can see where our tiles are placed, and yeah, obviously this just needs to clear up more because we're using cycles. But once it clears up quite nicely, you'll actually see how cool it's actually looking, how much more realistic it's looking. And you'll even see how the tiles are looking a lot more 3D-like. They're popping out a bit, just enough. All right, guys, so until the next video, we're going to keep adding in here. See you then, guys. You like this video, so hit subscribe. And, that'll just really, really help us promote our channel and what we're doing here at Active TV. Go check out the other items on our playlist. Until next week. Well, not next week, until the next video. And check if the next video is there, because it might just be there. But yeah, in part 2 of what's
all about humanity. It's all about humanity.